you are having a good day today. For me, today's one of those days where everything seems to be off or weird or strange or out of control. So it's one of those things where you just have to be like, okay, I'm not in control. What are the things that I can control? So like today, I can control how much of my paper I'm going to write for school, or I can control how I continue to respond to, maybe if I'm frustrated, how I can continue to respond to that. And for me, I'm going to keep moving through it. I'm going to keep moving. I'm not just going to lay down like I would love to do. But anyway, today, how am I? So that is the grounding question for today. That is the question to bring you back to the present, is how am I? And that is the question to ask yourself. So how are you? Asking yourself, how am I? How am I today? Who am I? Where am I? What am I doing? So there's a little bit of grounding question for you today. How am I? And I encourage you, if you can't figure out feelings, if you're like, I'm happy, I'm sad, I'm tired, I'm not, if those are where you're at right now, I encourage you to maybe look up, like Google, or get a dictionary or a thesaurus, and look up feelings, look up different things, look up different words for happy, or look up different words for tired, or look up different words for frustrated, or look up different words for powerless, or not feeling like you're in control. Look up words for control. So I encourage you to do that today and ask yourself, how am I? How am I today? And that is a super good exercise to bring yourself back to center, to ground yourself to where you are right now, to ground yourself to the present. And that's one of the most important things that to keep us in control, to keep us healthy and safe, being present is a super valuable and important tool and exercise to use and to get stronger with. As you can see, I'm having problems with talking today. So let's go ahead and, after we've gotten that question, that how am I? Find your answer for how am I. Right now, I'm flustered, but flustered in a comedic sort of way. So that's how I am right now. So I'm going to allow myself to move through that space and to make some space for myself. So I encourage you to do the same. To whatever space you're in, maybe you're in the frustrated space, maybe you're in the anxious space, maybe you're in a depressive space, make space around that. Go ahead and move yourself through that. Maybe moving from side to side, maybe rocking from side to side, and if you're sitting, again, maybe rocking from side to side, or maybe rocking front and back, or if you're standing, you can rock front and back with one foot in front, one foot in back. But I encourage you to move today. Move through your how am I. And then find out after your how am I, let's inhale, how am I? And exhale, I'm kind of flustered. And inhale, how am I? And exhale, but I'm outside. And inhale, how am I? And exhale, and it's a beautiful day. And inhale, how am I? And exhale, and I feel okay, and that's okay. Maybe roll our shoulders, and then rolling the other way, and then maybe opening up those shoulders, opening up that back, maybe doing a little bit of swimming arms. And then again, make your movements big. You have space. Take up your space. Take up the room. I know for many of you, trauma has caused you to become small and to become invisible and to want to not have any space around. But take up your space. Grab your space. And it can be, you can be by yourself. Go outside. Grab your space. experiment with having space. And maybe moving that. And if you've got kids, maybe asking the oldest to watch the youngest, or if they're little, maybe finding someone that you can say, hey, can you take 5 minutes and watch these guys while I go out and breathe and find some space and clear my head? So important for you, so valuable. You are important. You are worthy of space, and you are worthy of breathing, and you are worthy of your head being clear so that you can take on the rest of your tasks, the rest of your day. And you are worthy of figuring out, how are you? So asking yourself, how am I? Shiloh is choking. They're eating the grass down here and laying down. But let's inhale, how am I? And exhale, I am here. And inhale, how am I? And exhale, I am standing on the ground. And inhale, where am I? And exhale, I am outside. And inhale, what is around me? And exhale, trees and a road and grass and dogs. And inhale, how am I? And exhale, I'm a little calmer now. Where am I? Inhale, where am I? And exhale, I am someplace where I have space and where I feel safe. Inhale, how am I? And exhale, my head feels a little clearer. So I encourage you, practice that today. Use that exercise. How am I? Where am I? What am I doing? How am I feeling? Who is around me? What is around me? What do I smell? What do I see? So again, use those senses. Ground yourself. Center yourself. Because again, you deserve that. You deserve that centering. You deserve to be aware of what is around you. You deserve to be aware of how you are feeling. You deserve that time and that space. Let's do 4-4-4-4. So we're going to inhale for 4, hold for 4, exhale for 4, hold for 4. So let's inhale for 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold it for 4, 3, 2, 1, and exhale for 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold it for 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale for 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold for 4, 3, 2, 1, and exhale 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold for 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do that one more time. Inhale for 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold for 4, 3, 2, 1, and exhale 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold for 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. And again, make your space. Move yourself around. And I encourage you, if you need to do this a bunch of times today. Do this a lot today. Take your 5-minute breaks. Or if you feel like you need more movement, there's plenty of yoga on this channel. There's plenty of stretching. There's a few aerobics. There's some fibro and chronic fatigue movement for you. But I encourage you to find something today. Move through something. How am I? Where am I? What am I doing? What am I seeing? How am I feeling? So maybe investigating that today. Let's inhale it again up, because the air is so nice today. Inhale and sweep it up. And exhale and press it out. And inhale and lift it up. And exhale and press it out. I encourage you to go outside. There's a nice breeze blowing, and just the energy of that breeze. Just the beauty of what is around me. It's so open. And that is a good thing to feel. Free and open. Know that you are seen, that you are heard, that you are important, that you are valuable. And also, I encourage you, remember, if you are feeling out of control, if you are feeling anxious, if you are feeling powerless. Yes, there's this big old thing that we cannot control that's going on around us still, but what we can control is how we respond, how we interact with others, how we interact with the world around us, the information that we choose to take in, and how we can serve others. So take this time, allow yourself to be centered, to be present, allow yourself some freedom today, and again, know that you are seen, you are heard, you are important, you are valuable, and embrace the things that you can control and how you can respond. All right, we'll see you guys next time. Bye. So last week or two weeks ago, I don't know, I shared with you the cactus, the Bakersfield cactus, and we'll get over there in a minute and I'll show you a little bit more. But it's really cool out here. On the trails, there's all kinds of benches, and then there's little things that talk about like the habitat or like where the ocean used to be, that sort of thing, about the Kern River, all that sort of stuff. So if you ever come out here, and then like I said, there's a little bathroom, but Bakersfield cactus, an endangered beauty, and we'll walk over here and look at the cactus. And stay away from it. There we go. Nature.